Hi, everybody, and welcome to Paul Listening Behind the Curtain. It's my opportunity to step away from the worlds of politics and law you watch me cover on television every day into the far more fun world of theater and the arts. And I suppose the story of today's show and today's guest, if you actually look back to when it happened, might have crossed lines with the world of politics. When you think about it, but we won't go there too much. We're talking about the incredible Broadway musical being, it's back in Chicago, presented by Broadway in Chicago with the Nederlander Theatre, the very huge hit, Six. And joining me are two of the wives. We'll find out if both of them survived their time with Henry VIII. I know one of them didn't. Anyway, but this is the story of the six wives of Henry VIII, hence it is called Six. And so joining me is Alize Cruz, who plays Katherine Howard, and Cassie Silva, who plays Anne Boleyn.
Hello.
I kind of think, isn't Anne Boleyn, maybe it's because of Anne of a Thousand Days or something, but is she kind of more famous that we kind of are not quite sure who Katherine Howard is these days, or are we?
You know, I think Anne Boleyn is just kind of the most famous of the six wives, which is interesting because Catherine of Aragon actually was the longest reigning. But yeah, I mean, she was pivotal because, of course, she had the whole entire church overturned.
Well, yeah, exactly. And I love that this is a history lesson. And think of the politics. I said I cover politics, so this. So yeah, Alize, let me defend. Have you defend Katherine Howard? So tell us the role that Katherine played in Hank's life.
Katherine Howard. So Katherine Howard was the youngest of the wives, actually, and. Katherine Howard was technically, they would say, the one that Henry was most infatuated with. She was young and she was beautiful. And so there was a time, there's a story that Katherine Howard is kind of the promiscuous one, the one that would see other men while she was with Henry VIII. And that actually hurt him. So I think that she was the first person he actually was hurt by when she started going to see other people, whereas the other wives he just kind of tossed and was like, okay, we're done. But with her, he was hurt. He was actually hurt.
And by the way, when people see you on stage, because I'm not that we see you right now, so and I'll ask both of you this, but Alize, you don't look like this when you're on stage.
Nope.
And you went right for the hair. How do we see you on stage, just so when people haven't seen the show say, oh, that's Alize?
Yes, I have a long pink Ariana Grande ponytail. It's huge and it goes all the way down. And yeah, I have a tight little, tight classic outfit on and it's pink. Everything's pink.
It's so great. And Cassie, you have a different color scheme.
Yes, well, each queen kind of has an iconic piece. And fun fact, the costumes that Gabriella Slade designed are actually the reigning Tony Award winning costumes.
So good.
Oh, you mean they're copies of it, they're actual ones?
These costumes that Gabriella Slade designed that we wear are the Tony Award winners for best costume.
Oh, wow. And there were lots of Tonys going to that show. So yeah.
Yes.
Oh, that's great. And yours is a very bright green.
Yes. So I am the green queen. I wear two buns on my head and very stick straight hair. I call the skirt the broccoli skirt, lovingly. And I have these like big green shoulders, which is very fun. And then, of course, for the green sleeves, yeah, I have two little cuffs.
I just love, I'm sure you guys know all the history, but you do know all these. You know, this show began here in Chicago. And
yeah.
Not as a Broadway thing. Can you just share whatever history you know? I'll fill in if you don't, but talk about the history of this show.
I'm not, Cassisha is the person to ask about the history of the show.
Okay, let's go for it. Cassie, you take that question. That's fine. That's good. Cassie, give us the history because it goes back to Chicago Shakespeare.
Sure. Yes. Yeah. So the show originated on the West End. It came here and it was at Chicago Shakes. Then it went to Broadway. And then, of course, we had the pandemic. Reopened on Broadway. We then opened the first national tour at the CIBC. And that was in 2022. Mm-hmm. And I know my time. and then the second national opened shortly thereafter, and now we are back at the Nederlander, which is so exciting to play in all of the houses.
Yeah, and you know, and it's because, again, Chicago Shake's a smaller venue, whatever, and now at this point, they're just giving you one of the huge venues because the people go nuts over this show. And I also want to assume people are watching us to kind of check it out, like, oh, maybe they haven't seen it, so they want to learn something. So Alize, sure. I'll come to you with, let's kind of explain what the show is, because if you think you're watching, when I was in high school, I starred in Anne of a Thousand Days.
Okay.
This is not that.
No.
And maybe that's why I think the way I do about Anne Boleyn, just because it's like, well, I was in the show and I got to wear a little goatee and everything. But anyway, so Alize, give us why is it that all of these young people, it's not a kid show by any means, but all these young people, I was there opening night and I've seen it before, right. But everybody is in crowns. Actually, a lot of men are in crowns too, and wearing purple.
Oh, good.
So the appeals to everybody. But what, Alize, what is it we are in for? We're not in for just for a Shakespeare play.
No, absolutely not. I think six is just the definition of triumph and celebration. And the six queens, I think why people come dressed up is because they relate to one of us queens in some way. And they just love either the story or their song or just the character of that queen. But our show is like a modern day pop concert telling the history of Henry VIII and his six wives. But instead of it being from the outside perspective, it's from the wives' perspectives. It's what we experienced. I say we, but it's what we experienced in our lives with Henry VIII and what we want to take from those lives from Henry VIII. So everyone learns that history lesson, but leaves with like a sense of a voice and just happiness and like, we can do it. And camaraderie. And it's just, oh, it's so fun.
And the truth is, and so many of you represent sort of pop icons. I mean, it is, it's like, you know, I don't know about all the pop icons, but whether it's Britney Spears, name some icons, but you know, Beyonce. I mean, yeah, we go there, we have this feeling that these are the ladies we're seeing. So I'm sort of curious, Cassie, so when you up there, are you saying, no, I'm Anne Boleyn, that's what I'm doing? Or are you thinking to yourself, you know, there's this pop star thing going on? I mean, it's like, you guys, my review of the show, my kind of headline of the show was, the show is electric. And I really feel that way. But electric, not because they plugged in, but the lighting, the costumes, I've never been in a show where like the lighting is a character. It's just stunning.
It's great. Okay,
talk to me. When you're up there, are you going, I'm Evelyn, or are you going, I kind of get that I'm a pop star here?
I kind of think that it's a little bit of both. You know, the writers created the show to display and celebrate their friends. And we sort of liken them to these pop icons, like Boleyn is likened to a Lily Allen. I personally relate, you know, my Anne Boleyn to a Demi Lovato mixed with like a little bit of Ariana Grande or a Renee Rapp or an Olivia Rodrigo.
By the way, was that directed to you? Because you just said I make her. Are these your choices or director choices?
Sure. That's such a great question, because one thing that I love about Six is that our creative team encourages and celebrates who we are individually and our take on the role. So that's part of why Six is so fun. You can come a million times. One, because it's fun. And two, because no matter. So we have 10 people. We have 4 offstage, 6 on stage, which are who you see. And then we have 1 universal. So depending on who you see on stage that night, you are getting a totally different rendition of somebody's individual take on that queen.
And Alize, I thought it was fun. On opening night, you probably noticed this because I did. I usually sit in the first couple of rows. So I was in the second row, but then there was this woman front row center. She was not a young kid, but she was on her feet dancing. You know who I'm talking about? I don't know who she is, but I mean, she was just up there and she was connecting. Because the thing is, you guys do sort of break that fourth wall. You know we're there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We call the audience the seventh queen.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Well, she certainly took it on seriously.
Yes.
And I thought it was great, Cassie, when you said, please sit down. No, you didn't do that. No, do you actually, Alize, do you like when you see audience members of whatever age? I mean, you know, getting up, they're really moved.
Absolutely. I mean, that's We want to know, as queens, that you are with us on our story and you're coming on that journey with us. So yes, make the noise and stand up and dance and sing along with it. I love it. I love it. It makes me more nervous when that doesn't happen, actually. Mm-hmm. So please, please make all the noise. I hope to see you standing up and dancing with us.
Well, I'll do, I'm coming again. So this time I will definitely wave and hopefully you'll give me that little, hey, Paul. That's always nice. So in fact, let me ask you, I want to do this earlier in our interview, but I'm going to be back. I'm going to say the date, because so don't follow me there, people. But anyway, I will be back on July 6th and it's a Saturday and there are two shows that day and both shows on that day are really pretty special. For those who, you know, listen, there are people on every night who are singing along. And when I would like to tell them to please stop on July 6th, you're going, no, today we'll let them come. Why? Cassie, we'll take
yes, July 6th is the sing-along. It's the 6th sing-along. We're so excited.
Have you done this before? Have you done the sing-along before?
I've experienced it once, but not on stage. But let me tell you, no matter where stage, you are, and that, I was an offstage queen at that point. But let me tell you, for all involved, and I can speak for everyone, that was hands down our favorite show we've ever done. I mean, you're talking about electric, like,
I can't wait.
Wow. Oh my gosh. I cannot wait. Especially in a space this big, like the Nederlander. It's going to be so exciting.
So can you just, so you understand, because I'm coming to my partner. He will be on his feet singing or whatever it is you tell him to do. So Alize, how will it work? Will there be, I mean, is there a prompter that you have to be putting the words up? Or are we getting a, how will that work? Do you know?
I've not been a part of any of the sing-alongs. However, I heard something about like a screen of words. Am I wrong, Cassie, when I'm saying there's like a screen with the lyric?
Honestly, I don't know, but I'm going to guess
there is. You know, when they have certain kind of caption performances and stuff, that's what they do. And there's a screen. So they, I mean, you can't have a sing-along and say, hope you all know the words, right?
Right.
So yeah, they will probably.
I wish I could tell you.
Now, do you expect, get back to us. So we'll let you know.
Get back to you.
And Alize, let me ask you this. So here's the thing. So you play to the audience anyway. And of course, you know, I know you're making contact, but on this day, I'm sort of curious, do you anticipate this will be new for you? Do you anticipate like, no, I'm doing the show the way I always do it. And I'll break the wall as I usually break it. Or do you think, because you haven't done this before, do you think that if this audience is really part of the cast, I have to even do that more. I've got to break through more. I've got to truly connect. Maybe you'll be in the aisles. I don't know what they're going to do with you.
I see what you're saying. And I think in my personal experience, just based on who I am as a person, I'll probably play more into that because they're already kind of going to join the story with us by singing our songs. I think it would be a lot more fun to include them in on some of the jokes we tell on stage, you know, like, and another thing that we do, even now, we play a different show every night by saying something different or doing something funny on stage to make each other laugh.
Oh, now wait again. So are you saying there's a little ad-libbing that might go on?
Not ad-libbing per se, just character choices, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, I think what we're really doing, again, like the audience is the seventh queen, so depending on what the audience is, depending on who the six on stage are, we really are just acting and reacting, and so,
exactly.
Yeah.
It's the reacting, they're going to give us.
Like Cassie, you wouldn't take it as Anne to a point where like, you know, director would chop your head off over this or anything.
That was good.
I see what you did there. No, you know, I mean, our team actually gives us so much definition in terms of intention. Mm-hmm. And so we do have a bit of space to breathe so long as we do keep it within the confines of our director and their wishes for the show.
And I'm sure there'll be freedom on that day. And, Alize, I have to say, I sure like everybody, the band could be off. They could be in the pit. They could be elsewhere. They're not. Uh-huh. They're therefore, maybe if you say the audience is the seventh character, they're the eighth. But I think actually maybe they're the seventh character.
Right.
And we'll take the role of eighth. But here's the thing. I find myself and you watching them. I'm sort of curious if you, I mean, you talk to the band members and stuff. There's some who seem to recognize that they're kind of a character in their facial expression.
Yes.
And then there's, I'm thinking of one, I won't say anything, but there's one who sort of like, seems I'm just there, but I don't want to interfere with what's going on. What do you know? What is their mindset?
Well, sometimes, and I actually asked them this the other day, because we do kind of interact with them and we make faces with them or we say things to them.
They're there, but they're not there.
Yes. So they're listening to the pianist. They're listening to the conductor in their in-ears. So sometimes if they seem out of it, it's because they're listening to the track. They're listening to when they're supposed to come in, or they're just really focused on what's going to happen next. Because sometimes that music comes out of nowhere, right? So a lot of them have been doing the show a really long time, so they kind of know when all these things are coming. However, sometimes you'll have that moment of just, they really need to tune in. And that's the explanation for that.
So is that your traveling band, Alize, or are any of them Chicago-based and they're here for this production?
So, no, they come in, they travel with us. Yeah, they'll come in with us, but sometimes if somebody's out, we'll have a replacement in who's from a different cast, and they'll just fly in and out. So it's sometimes a mixture. And same with us as queens, there's sometimes a mixture of who's on and who's not.
Yeah, well, and I was going to say, because even look, I mean, I look at your bios and stuff. So you yourselves have gone through, a bit of history of where you understood. Actually, there was one of you had this. I thought it was interesting. I wanted to ask what it was. Which was, Alize, that was you. You were the rehearsal swing.
Yes.
What did that mean?
Yes. So my first cast of six was on Norwegian Cruise Lines. And a rehearsal swing, you have your six on stage, and then you have your two swings that will go onto the ship. Now, a rehearsal swing, essentially, you learn the whole show covering three characters. And if somebody on the ship injures themselves or has to leave for whatever reason, we then get sent onto the ship. That never happened. So I learned the show for 3 weeks, never did it again until now.
You never thought of tripping somebody or, you know?
Never, ever. I learned that I didn't like ships because they move too much. So I'm glad.
They do do that.
They do move. And by the way, Cassie, I'm guessing on the ship, either of you can answer, but because the show's not that long, it's only about 85 minutes or so. So, and because I know on cruise ships and Vegas and places like that, they cut things down, but I don't know that they had to for this show.
No, I mean, it's the same. Alize, I don't know too much about the ship, but
right.
Is it the same?
Look how I go to the wrong person every time.
No, it's okay. Cassie did all the on land things. I did the ship.
She's the land shark and you are the, yeah.
Right. No, the ship was essentially the same thing. I would say the only difference was some choreography here and there. The Cleves costume reveal is not a thing on the ships. So
is that because of a kid thing? What do we mean?
Oh, what?
Is it the costume reveal, it's an audience thing or it's just something that had to be?
I'm not supposed to say.
Oh, you can't say. Okay. Oh, you can't say because of the surprise here for people to see.
Go ahead, dude.
Listen, I always tell this story. I didn't think of the surprises in this show, but whenever I have a cast, I will often say, is there anything you don't want me to do? I don't want to give anything away. And my favorite example of that was when I had the cast of Dear Evan Hansen, and one of them said, don't mention that Connor dies. And I went, Connor dies in the first 5 minutes of the show. What is the surprise about that? You know?
Oh my gosh.
So totally. I give anyway. So no, thank you. I don't want you to give it. And I've had some
Thanks,
shows
where
there's so many secrets. Like the cast members with me look at each other like, I don't know what we can't.
Sure. Well, you know what's really interesting is that six is so bare bones. I mean, you said it. The lights are like the lights, the band. Like we really create a whole world, like a pop concert. Mm-hmm. And we only have a throne and two props and you know a secret here or there. So. actually that was a glow up. Like we've had a glow up in our show. And so I think that it's able to be played with because it wasn't, you know, some things weren't originally in them.
Yeah.
So.
No, the set is so you could do this in my home.
Yeah,
correct. And really? You know what?
What are you doing tonight? Oh, you got a show.
We got a show.
So can I ask you, I don't want this to be an unfair question, but you've already indicated through some of your comments, you seem to know a little bit about the history of your characters. Mm-hmm. And years ago, I interviewed a particular actress and she played a historic role. And I asked her, I thought it was a normal question, sort of like, oh, talk about like the research you did for this historic character that you play. I mean, if I told you the actor and the role, you'd go, oh yeah, totally, I know what you're talking about. And the answer to me was, well, I didn't do any research. And I went, what? Yeah, they gave me the script. I memorized the script and I performed that person. And which even though it was a really well-known person, was like, what? So I'm curious. So I'm going to ask you that question. I get a sense that you didn't just say, who am I, Anne Boleyn? Okay, I'm ready to be Anne Boleyn. It sounds to me like you did some homework, both of you and probably all of you did some homework here. Cassie, what did you?
Oh, yeah, sure. So we are given actually tools, historical tools. We have to
Like a
learn
dramaturg
these
kind of a thing?
100%. So I have like sheets that are, front and back flipped, with the history, the timeline of each queen. One thing that I personally love about Boleyn is that she was known as the most happy.
And
Which is so true.
does that
Yes.
impact your performance?
Yes, absolutely. We also study the Lucy. Oh my gosh, I'm something with a W. Oh gosh, I'm so terrible. I've seen it so many times at this
The
point.
documentary.
The documentary. We watch the documentary series. And then we also watch the Beyonce Homecoming tour. Which is also very fun to sort of get that pop star. I've also, like read different books or, like there's the other Boleyn girl. I love to just see iterations because there are so many accounts. And that's why six is fun because you're giving their personal account of things.
And
Yeah,
Alize, oh, I'm sorry. I just wanted, what work did you, given the fact that you never went on, I imagine you're backstage every night on the ship just going, give me another book to read about this lady. I've already read Catcher in the Rye 4 times, so.
To Kill a Mockingbird, come on. I mean the same thing. So they give us all the same, work to do. So the documentaries, the books, and things like that. And I think one of the interesting things I learned as being a rehearsal swing and learning multiple characters, a lot of our queens were actually in the lives of each other in real life. Like our characters were cousins in real life.
Beheaded cousins.
Beheaded cousins. Yeah. So the things you learn, it's really incredible. And to piggyback on
You say that in the show? I don't remember. Do we hear that in the show?
not cousins. We don't say anything about cousins, but we
We
are the two
don't.
beheaded ones. We do
Okay,
hear
so on the
that.
sing-along day when I'm there again, say
Yeah.
something like, hey, cuz.
Well,
Oh,
we do. We like sprinkle it in. There's one moment where we go together and we high five and then we like go like this. So it's kind of our like little nod to the fact that we are cousins. But yes,
By the
I
way,
love what you said, Alize.
I think Cassie, some people don't realize, I mean, Hank, I like to call him Hank. Hank, he didn't kill everybody.
No,
No.
he did
No,
not.
Jane Seymour, the only one he truly loved, died,
Who's still acting today?
who is still, wait, say again?
Jane Seymour is a famous
Jane
actor.
Seymour. She came to the show in LA.
Oh, really?
Yes, we got to meet her.
Did you call her up on stage and say, ladies and gentlemen, the real Jane Seymour?
No, but she came up pre-show and we got to take a picture with her and everything. And she is
Oh,
just so
good. I'm so glad
beautiful.
you knew who that was. Otherwise, that joke was going to fall flat.
Dr. Quinn, medicine woman? Absolutely.
I think that is so wonderful. So you do the research, you know who these people are. I'm actually thinking of doing a show which are the 9 husbands of Elizabeth Taylor.
Can I be Elizabeth Taylor?
Absolutely. You kind
Great.
of have that look. Why not?
Thank
And I don't
you.
know whether to be Michael Todd or Richard Burton, or Richard Burton
Oh my.
again. You'll need two Richard Burtons.
Honestly,
Different picture.
that could be good.
That's so funny.
I'll say, why do you think, I don't know the history in terms of, like, why do you think, if you know, if you don't, you don't. Cassie probably knows. Why do you think somebody decided to say, we need to write, that this is a good idea, that let's take the 6 wives of Henry VIII, and there's this pop musical to be told. What a
You know
creative
what's
idea. Who
insane?
thought of it?
We were so lucky to be able to talk to the creators of the show.
Oh, okay.
And this began as a college project. It was a show that they were writing in college. But from what I took from Toby and Lucy, who are the creatives, they just wanted to write a show telling a story of history that all of their friends could be a part of. And it's not, Cassie, help me figure out the word. It's not restrictive on who can play any character. They wanted anyone to be able to play these characters and really put their own spin on each of us queens. So
Well,
is
now
it
I'm just picturing a bunch of people in college having some drinks and whatever, writing together, and they create this Tony Award-winning masterpiece.
how could you even expect it to turn into this? It's insane.
Yeah, I mean, they say that like because it started so small, they never ever expected it to be filling houses like a giant place like the Nederlander. They said, you know, we basically were just like pulling things from our closet and, you know, like putting, you know, fake crowns on. And of course, it was hysterical because you knew that we weren't taking it seriously. So in some ways, it was easier to portray that this was a comedy, if you will. But they're like, and now we're like full on Beyoncé's. Like, what do we even do with this? So they're really good at honing us back into the original like roots of the piece.
So I have to, Cassie, I'll stay with you, but you can both respond. I've got to ask the Chicago question. You're here till July 14th. That is a longer run than a lot of the Broadway and Chicago shows that come in for 5 days or 6 days or a week, something like that, for, you know, various reasons. They're all on national tours. You're on a national tour. So I'm sort of curious, number one, because I don't know the answer to this. Is this a longer stay in Chicago than you are staying in other cities?
Oh, absolutely. So this is the longest. So we're on the second national tour. This is one of the longest runs that this tour has done so far. Before we got here, we had done 1-weekers. I think we did 1 2-weeker in Cincinnati. But other than that, we have traveled on our days off for the last couple of months. So this
this is nice.
Yeah.
Well, I feel like Chicago feels like we own this show. You know, and it just obviously it was birthed here in many ways. Forget the West End, but it was birthed here, and you know, and grew up here. And Alize, talk to me about Chicago, because you're traveling and you're seeing audiences all over, and I know what answer I expect. But do you find that Chicago audiences are more sophisticated and whatever than lots of other cities? With all due respect to other cities,
I love the Chicago audiences because they give us all the energy we ask for. But they never overdo it. They never cut us off. They never, you know, they let our jokes land before cheering. I find them very respectful and very much theater audiences. But when we give them the go ahead to react, it's beautiful. And I just, I love it. They don't. You guys are just so respectful. You just don't overdo it. I love you guys.
Do you have more fun playing with us and to us than maybe in another city?
We have had so much fun here. Because sometimes in other cities, you know, the demographics are maybe older people who like shows more like West Side Story. You know what I mean? So having such a variety of audience here has been so fun. Because sometimes you'll see a ton of kids in the audience. Or you won't at all. And you'll see a lot of adults. So it's fun to pick and choose, you know, how you're going to play that character that day based on the audience.
And with 2 weeks, Cassie, you get a little free time here and there. So I got to ask, what are your favorite things to do in Chicago? Have you had Lou Malnati's pizza? Are you eating Garrett's pop? Well, given the dresses you're wearing, you ain't eating Garrett's caramel corn popcorn every night.
Okay, listen, don't sleep on Garrett's popcorn. No, every time I come here, I do the boat tour. I know we're looking at doing a sunset one right now.
Yeah. I hope you do the architectural boat tour.
Is that what it is? The architectural?
Well, there's different boat tours. So I'm not tied to any of them, but Chicago's First Lady is where you have architectural docents guide the tour and give you the history of the buildings.
That's the one you want to do. So good. I mean, of course, going to the river. What else? The museums, like the Field Museum, the Art Institute.
Yeah.
Also, Joffrey Ballet, we love.
Do you get to see other shows while you're here? I mean, there's
Yeah, that and also like taking class. I mean, I'm a dancer, so just being that close to things or there's so much to do. The food.
Yeah. I had Lou Malnati's the first week we got here.
Is that not the best? I differ, but I think it's the best.
It was delicious. It's a deep dish pizza. It's the first time I had a deep dish pizza, and it makes sense, right? Like you have to in Chicago. And it was so good. I couldn't eat a lot because we had a show, but it was worth it.
You got to put that dress on. You know, it's funny. Yesterday I interviewed some cast members from SNL, including James Austin Johnson, who plays the Trump character and the Biden character. And so I asked them about, you know, what they like to do in Chicago, because James has been here before. And he goes, well, I got to watch my girlish figure. I can't do the pizza. And then one of the other cast members looked at him and said, what are you talking about? You play Trump. You can eat as much pizza as you want.
Called him out.
Yikes.
Oh my gosh.
So much fun. But the other thing, Cassie, is like, as you walk in, here's because your costumes are so dynamic. I don't know. Do you get like, because this is the way I am on TV. So people who see me on the street and recognize me want to talk politics usually and that kind of thing. But you're out of costume. You ever want to kind of wear your costume down the street on Michigan and Avenue so people can say, oh, now I know who you are?
100%. I mean, I'm kind of known for always wearing green to like help it out. Yes.
But wait, because of the show, or that's your color?
Well, that's in our show, Anne Boleyn's color because of green sleeves. And so.
Kind of yours now, too. You're wearing green.
I am wearing green.
It's become her personality.
I am very green. But
you should play Elphaba.
Listen, from your mouth to God's ears. No, well, you know what's so interesting is that our costumes are actually very heavy and they're very cumbersome. So they're made of plastic. Our ladies in waiting are made from vinyl. They're very heavy. Aragon, the gold queen, her costume is upwards of 12 to 15 pounds. Like we are hauling these around the stage. Hopefully we make them look graceful.
You do, because I had no idea. I mean, and I guess I would ask the question, Alize, how could they do that to you? Here, wear this 80-pound costume for the next hour and a half.
You're asking the wrong person. I wear almost nothing.
Oh, well, okay, that's true. Oh, so yours is not heavy.
Mine's not heavy. The only thing is my corset is quite tight. There's not a lot of give. So if I eat too much, and the same with my skirt. If I eat a little too much or too much salt that day, it will not feel great.
So you must have dressers who help you, right?
We do. Yes.
And how much are you playing, Cassie, with the other cast members? I mean, it's so funny. When I first asked, I said, I'd like to talk to, you know, the cast of six. And the answer was, well, I don't know if we can get all six. I went, I don't mean all six. We're not going to bother everybody here. But let's give me some fun. And you guys are great fun.
Oh, thank you.
Do you find, I mean, are you all friends? Or do you basically say, you know, I don't want to talk to Jane Seymour today. You know,
No, I think that we are all friends. You know, I pretty much could call anyone from any cast of six in America. I was lucky enough to play the Universal for 6 months, which meant I played four queens and could go between any company. Wow. And
do you ever get confused like from one night to another going, oh, but wait, I'm not Anne tonight or something like that?
Now, totally. I mean, I think I've done it enough in repetition that it doesn't so much seep in. But yeah, I've likened it to lanes in bowling, and I'm just always hoping that I don't throw the ball into another lane.
Lanes in bowling sounds very close to Anne Boleyn.
Yeah, the bowling, exactly.
Bowling, bowling.
There is a Broadway bowling league, and I have said if we had one, it would be. But we don't have enough people because our cast is so small. Yes, we are all very close, and you know, we spend every moment together. So there is kind of forced sisterhood, if you can understand that. Like, I probably could finish most people's sentences at this point. And it's so great. It's such a unique experience. Yeah. So
and my guess is the audience. I know Lin-Manuel Miranda told me that he goes, there's times that he, it happens. You drop a line. And he goes, and the audience says it for me.
Uh-huh. Of course.
I know you guys don't drop lines, but I mean, if that were to happen, do you have every belief that the audience would just toss it out to you?
One of us
would cover it.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, I know that doesn't happen, but my point being how much audiences love the show. Mm-hmm. That they, they're singing along with you. They know every word. They know everything that's going to happen. And they're just, ready to do whatever it is you need them to do.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, you know what's so interesting is the sing-along when we did it on Broadway, the audience was asked to please be respectful of the scenes in the show because, if we had just let them go, they probably would know every single line.
Yeah. God, I hope we don't ruin the show on the six now that I think about it.
It's fun. An exercise that we did before the sing-along is that those that weren't the six on stage, we would stand around the theater in different places and we would just scream, holler, and clap and like try to distract the six on stage.
Oh my God.
Oh, that's mean, but I love that.
Oh yeah. No, I lose focus so fast.
I love it. Well, I'm going to see you on July 6th because that's the day of the sing-alongs. Both the matinee and the evening will be sing-alongs. You'll need to recover after that. But in the meantime, Six is playing at the Nederlander Theatre through July 14th. So glad you're here that long. Tickets can be gotten at BroadwayInChicago.com. Our interview is going to be, of course, on the WGNRadio.com site, but also at AroundTheTownChicago.com, where people can see us there as well. And Alize, great name. And Cassie, thank you for being with me. Break legs every night, and I'll be waving at you from the second row on the 6th.
Yeah, cannot wait. I'll be...
Thank you. I love, yes.
Thank you.
We're going to make the contact. Thank you. Greg Legg. See you soon. Bye.
Thank you so Bye-bye. Much. Be well.